Good morning. This is the October 22nd meeting of the subcommittee, the reuse subcommittee of the Northampton Public Works Commission. Calling the meeting to order. And has everyone had a chance to go over the minutes from the September 17th meeting? All right. Any comments about the minutes? Blocking concerns? No? Okay. Do I have a motion to approve?
A motion.
Second? All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. CET partnership. Wow, right at the top of the agenda. Wow, you guys must be, well, I know how important you guys are.
I thought I'd get you in early. So everybody, this is Diana Vasquez and
Claire.
I'm sorry?
Cuzzo.
Cuzzo from CET. They are Eco Fellows, which is a program that CET has hiring young talent out of college. And
which colleges?
I'm from North Carolina, so I came from North Carolina State University.
Uh-huh.
I'm from New York, so I went to Stony Brook University.
So Ed Rutledge, who is the coordinator for the program, called me and wanted to see how they could partner with us as far as promoting our events and can we help promote some of their things as well. And so we had lunch and talked about some things that they could do. They're interested in tabling at some of our events, promoting some of their public programs, and they would also have our flyers at the tables at our program. So flyers about the recenter, flyers about new upcoming events that we're having, and then we can we're going to start having hopefully more things at the recenter. They're going to make a poster for us about Eco Building Garden, etc. And I'm going to let Diana explain more.
Yeah. Exactly. We just want to create some sort of partnership and be more in touch, since we are both in Northampton and we kind of have a similar mission, it seems like. Something that we do that we were talking about is CET goes on Mass Appeal about twice a month. So we're thinking we could give like shout outs to the reuse committee and events that y'all host.
What is Mass Appeal?
Mass Appeal is a daytime talk show. That's Brittany and Seth. They're the hosts. It's like a local.
It's like a lifestyle television
on
segment.
What station?
It's on 22.
NBC.
Yes. Yes, it's a TV show. But we go on this month in October. It's actually three times this month, I think.
Oh,
with three segments we have this month.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So we'll be going on next week too. So if there's anything coming up,
yeah, we can give like a quick shout out. Mm-hmm. Whoever watches, I'm not sure how many viewers it has, but.
I've seen it.
Great show.
They're funny. Yeah, they're cute. Is there, how much do you guys know about the organization? Is there anything that you imagine or envision kind of where a partnership might go, things that you're interested in?
I think, you know, probably our knowledge of CET is very different amongst all of us. Some
mm-hmm.
of us have worked closely with CET,
mm-hmm.
so maybe a minute or two about CET would be great.
Yeah. Sure. So Center for Ecotechnology is located right in Florence, so really nearby. Our kind of tagline is we help people become more energy efficient and reduce waste. So we do that through a number of arms in the organization. So what we're part of, the Eco Fellowship is its own kind of branch, but we work in the outreach department. Outreach and marketing is kind of our thing. So really putting the face of CET, but a lot of what they do, they do home energy assessments. They work in new construction, helping people and businesses who want to build. Yes. They help a lot with LEED certification. We do a lot of outreach programs helping people to weatherize their homes. What else?
The Eco Building Bargain Store,
mm-hmm.
So we can reduce things going into landfills that are, you know, very usable and still.
How about Lorenzo's work?
Yeah, can you explain recycling works?
Oh, okay, recycling works. It's a good one.
Yeah.
It's just a way to connect haulers and people who need to get rid of or want to recycle a lot of, you know, let's say they have, for some reason, like 300. That was actually a case. Someone had like 300 wine bottles. Right? I don't really know what to do with this. So they get on recycling works and they type it in and they basically connect them with the right haulers so that they both benefit. It's really great. It's aimed towards businesses, but anyone can call. Yeah, actually.
And they do a lot of work with composting. Yes. So yes. They've been connecting a lot of businesses that are interested in starting to compost with,
What's the name of that section?
The Cycling Works.
Yeah. Oh, mm-hmm. And our green business department is Lorenzo, is the department here who you were talking about. And what the green business department does, or something that they've done a lot in this past year, is with the food waste ban that was put in last October, or was it the October before? I think it's last October, saying that if you're a business that produces more than 1 ton of waste per week, you have to divert it from landfills. And so that's something that CET, specifically Lorenzo, with green business department, has been helping restaurants and businesses do.
And that's statewide, isn't
it? That's statewide ban, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, no,
Lorenzo's work is statewide.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. No, he's been statewide, and they're actually working right now to expand a program like that into Connecticut as well.
So CET has a office in Pittsfield,
yes.
And in Northampton,
yes. Yes.
And in Florence.
Florence
is the Northampton.
Yes,
oh, okay.
And then
they
have the.
Market Street.
They were on Market, and they moved to the Cutlery Building.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Yeah, they needed a second office.
I see.
Getting big. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then we have the store in Springfield.
So the biggest connection I see is with Echo Building Bargains for as far as the recenter. And I just called the other day because somebody wanted to donate some storm windows. And of all the items that you listed, you were very specific about storm windows. It could be triple track. I mean, nothing else was that specific. So I could take them in. But I think having a regular pickup,
mm-hmm.
you know, arranging with Echo Building Bargains.
Absolutely. Yeah,
I don't know about a regular
John Gerstmann still running?
We don't want them to come out and not have it.
We've organized pickups regularly, and they come
okay.
when we have at least five things. Yeah.
A regular pickup is hard because then if there's nothing there, they've wasted.
But perhaps if we put in a system, if that's something that you think would be useful, maybe we could just do like a weekly check-in to see if there's materials here.
That would be good. You know, we can photograph stuff and just send you photographs
yeah,
and decide
great.
Whether
that'd
it's worth
great.
Coming to get.
I've called the dispatcher and she will organize a pickup whenever, you know, they've come twice.
There'd also be a threshold on either side. Then when you reach it, you make a call. So we have we have enough of these. We'll make the call. We have all of these.
Okay.
Or if there's something you're looking for, and call and see if we've got it.
Yeah.
We've talked about having a poster made with pictures of the types of things that you guys will always take that we can put up at the recenter.
That's a great idea. That's a really good idea.
Yeah. Because there are certain things that sell really that move very quickly.
Could we put something like that up here as well, the transfer station?
Possibly, I don't know. I mean, that's the kind of thing that I'd have to check with the powers that be. I don't know. I mean, part of the problem with working with a municipality or a challenge is that if you do for one, you need to do for all. So there's like a precedent kind of issue. So if we were to post something about another organization here at the transfer station, then somebody who had a similar kind of public service kind of bent asked for it, it would be hard to say no.
Right.
So then it starts getting out of control. So at the recenter, we're very specifically looking to reduce the waste stream, and we could invite, if somebody else did something similar and wanted to put up another poster, we could at the recenter. But at the transfer station, it's a slightly different animal.
Okay. Ralph?
I would just like to say I think this is a wonderful idea, and I also think it reflects one of your original goals, which was to reach out and have other groups that we're working with. So it dovetails really well with that, and it clearly benefits both of us. And I think it's a great step forward in this direction.
Right now, I
Roger.
I would also say, like you're talking about Recycling Works, right? Where you're trying to hook up people who have weird things or large numbers of things to recycle. It'd be nice if the work goes into a more of a reuse stream as well. Concepting that way. So if you've got 100 wine bottles, well, maybe there's an artist somewhere that could use it.
Yeah.
Looking at those kind of networks.
So the Recycling Works program, it's like a web database So we don't actually, we don't control the content on there, but that's something that we could bring up to maybe.
We did something like that too, right? Yeah. What Anna did.
To make
Kate. Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
Yep. No, I mean, we've developed something that needs to, yeah.
Yeah, so we can get those connected.
Yeah.
We've got a much bigger network.
Yeah. There's definitely a cause up, there's definitely potential out there.
Yeah.
John Meyerchuk, did I pronounce his name correctly? Who is the executive director of CET, is involved with the Reuse Connex convention. He is, I believe, the chair of, I don't know what it's called, but it's the committee that's looking to find outside activities for convention attendees to do that are related to reuse in probably the Boston area. So he's involved and is very gung-ho about reuse. So I don't think it's outside of the realm of your
Absolutely not.
In our scope.
Right. So I wanted to give you a copy of this, and I will send you the PDFs. You mentioned your mass appeal and that you're going to be on it a lot.
Mm-hmm.
That's our November 7th event.
Okay.
That is free to the public, and we're collecting styrofoam bikes for Bikes Not Bombs, and there's going to be a shredder. Bulky rigid plastics. And the coolest thing, not the coolest, but the one of the most exciting things for us is the bulky rigid plastics collection, because what we do is we put all of the usable stuff that still has life in it out on the lawn that
mm-hmm.
people bring us for recycling, and people can shop before, before it gets recycled.
Great.
So not only can people bring, but they can take something home, or somebody can just come and pick up a little Tykes Play Yard or something like that for free.
For free.
So
okay.
whatever
great.
Is left,
awesome.
The remaining material at the end goes into the dumpster.
Wow.
And anything broken goes immediately into the dumpster. But
the dumpster is for recycling.
Yes.
It's
a collection
dumpster.
Yeah,
it's a collection dumpster. Right,
yeah.
right.
It's a pop-up recenter.
It does get, it is kind of a pop-up recenter. And John has coordinated these for a couple times now and has always been amazed at the amount of material that is taken home for reuse.
Yes.
Do you have anything
That's
to
great.
Add, John?
No, except that if you're going to talk about this,
mm-hmm.
and I don't know if it says it there, but the bikes are the only piece that's not totally free. They do ask for a
$10
donation. Okay.
Oh, is it
$3?
This one says
$3.
I thought it was $3. Is it $10?
That's what they asked for.
They asked for it.
It's a
donation. Bikes Not Bombs,
right?
$10?
Yeah. Oh, I thought it was
You don't have
$3.
To, though. It's a request.
I've been putting the
well,
word out that it's $3.
But it should be accurate. That's
okay.
what they're asking people.
Well,
yeah.
Oops.
Okay.
All
well.
Right.
Is there any way when you send us the PDF file of this that you could send us a write-up so that we can also post it to our
yeah,
Facebook page?
Yeah, I will send you the press release.
Excellent. That'd be
yeah.
great.
And yes. you're going on next when?
Next Thursday.
Yeah.
Do we have
so
photos
the only
from
thing
the recycling rally that we could send to them for their Facebook page? John, did you take any last time?
I didn't.
Oh, I
took
that.
Because you guys probably interested in posting some interesting photos, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
The one concern that I have, and maybe I'm just being paranoid, is because of the potential reach of mass appeal,
mm-hmm.
While it's open to the public,
yes.
it is volunteer run, and it's we are planning for what we usually get for the city of Northampton. So
mm-hmm.
if we get an influx of all these people bringing lots of styrofoam or whatever, that's, I don't know if we could easily handle that.
Is it still open for volunteer opportunities? That's
sure.
something that we could also put out there. That
I mean, we do have a lot of volunteers signed up for this
okay.
event on the 7th, but that's not always the case.
Okay. And then I mentioned to Diana and Ed, we have our toy exchange on the 12th, right? So that's another big one. But again, that's one that I hesitate to put out there,
right?
Because
mm-hmm.
it has gotten bigger every year, and we don't want it to become a monster that we can't
mm-hmm.
that we can't
we're,
handle.
And we're at that threshold.
And we're
right.
at that threshold. So
Roger,
I don't know that I would want it on mass appeal, frankly,
okay.
because
What about the cost of the recycling? But we're taking mostly local stuff and paying to have bulky plastics recycled. That's one cost. If we start getting a lot more, is the city going to want to pay for other people?
Well, one thing, that's a good point, Roger, and that's something that if you could mention when you discuss it, if you discuss it. Bulky rigid plastic, let me back up. Northampton and South Hadley were pilot programs for collecting bulky rigid plastic for the last couple of years. And as of, I think, last fall. Pilot through the materials recycling facility in Springfield, MRF. So we were the only two communities that were collecting bulky rigid plastic for recycling for a number of years. The MRF, as of last fall, I think, has opened that up. They are now permanently, or for the time being, they are now collecting bulky rigid plastic from any of their member communities.
Okay.
So a lot of member communities in the Springfield area are having bulky rigid plastic collections. So the first thing I would recommend is that they call their local DPW to see if they have a bulky rigid collection either at their transfer station or if they have them scheduled as a pop-up kind of seasonal thing.
Okay.
Our event's cooler though because we have the swapping.
Right. So is this something that you would like us to try to promote on Mass Appeal, or do you think this would be?
I don't know, based upon the traffic last year, I'd say bring it on.
And say that there's maybe possibilities in other communities.
Yeah, sure. We can say that Northampton.
That's your reporting.
You can just emphasize that we're trying to reduce the waste stream, especially durable, usable products.
Yeah, we're not in competition.
And that the greenest product is one that's already made.
Ro, you had a comment?
You know, I did, but I don't, this might be more for you guys on for Mass Appeal, but when we went to Gold Circuit, it seemed like he was saying that he needs to get as much styrofoam as possible.
He was saying that, yeah.
So, even if we don't promote it through us, you guys might promote it for him. Maybe talking to him about it.
Right. Yeah, that would make a lot more sense. If people have styrofoam, mm-hmm. it'd make a lot more sense for them to bring it straight to him.
Who is
Gold Circuit Recycling, his name is Matt.
He's in Springfield.
Ludlow.
And he is the, as far as I know, the only local collection site in the region.
Okay,
of styrofoam. For styrofoam. Yeah. And he wants white, large blocks of relatively clean and dry styrofoam.
And he actually needs it because for him as a business person, he needs to get a critical mass of items like this. And so the idea that I would check with him before I would mention that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, and one thing you might suggest is if their community doesn't have a collection for styrofoam, that your various community groups can hold a collection and bring it to him. So for instance, faith organizations, schools, you could have a styrofoam block collection drive kind of thing, and then he will, based on how much there is, he will either pick it up, it has to be quite a bit,
right.
Or you can bring it to him in Ludlow.
Great.
So awesome. I'm sure that he would be happy to.
Peter?
And just so it's clear, our event on the 7th is at Smith Oak.
Right. Mm-hmm. I did want to bring something up. October 20th, it's not a national reuse day, but maybe if you're all familiar with it, there's a movement to try to make it a national holiday. But October 20th is reuse day. And I was thinking, this past October 20th, we wanted to celebrate it. Unfortunately, we didn't have the correct liability insurance for the idea that we had. But I was wondering, maybe for next year, maybe that would be something we could partner and actually make a bigger celebration about. Just because it's such a cool, it's such a neat idea.
What was the idea you had?
We had an idea of making a crafternoon in our eco building bargain store. But we had a lot of kid oriented crafts, and unfortunately we didn't have liability insurance to have kids.
Minors.
Yeah, to have minors doing crafts in our store. We have a big conference room in the back of our store.
which we thought would be great to have like community members come in, because you have to walk through the store to get to the back of the store, obviously. So it just seemed like a good idea to get people in.
One of the events that we held here at our reuse center this September was a kind of reuse craft, repurposing craft fair.
Yeah, okay. It's fun. Case. It's fun, yeah, like people enjoy themselves.
And it would be nice to be able to maybe next year plan it for this event.
Yeah.
One of our concerns is we held it out at the reuse center, which is, have you ever been out there, by the way?
I have not.
Well, you should come out sometime.
Soon.
Soon. Open Saturday mornings. See what we have, but it's quite a ways away for a lot of people, and we're thinking that maybe we should do something like this closer in town next year.
Yeah.
But it's an interesting idea to see what people can do with stuff rather than throwing away.
Absolutely. I think that maybe
it's a great idea for next year,
The reuse fair.
And Roger has also been pushing the concept of repair workshops.
Repair cafes.
Repair cafes.
iFixit.
That's a great idea.
Concept.
Yeah, you guys would be great with iFixit.
What is a repair cafe?
Come online.
Okay.
It's an international organization. They got well over 400 communities doing it. And you bring your stuff in and it gets fixed. So they have you get a network of local people who do stuff. And Peter's working at it, right? Getting kind of pilot versions of lamp fixing, but you bring your, they have, we just had the last one in this field last weekend.
And you learn how to do it, right?
Well, the iFixit, they more or less require that you learn how to do it. You don't have to at a repair cafe, but you can watch them and they'll tell you what they're doing. And they're very cool, and you don't throw away stuff.
Oh, yeah, that's
cool. Oh, yeah, it's reducing the waste stream. And iFixit, I think their motto is if you can't fix it, you don't own it.
Is there anything else you guys want to discuss?
No.
All right. Thank you for coming.
Yeah,
welcome.
You're
stay for the rest of the meeting.
Do you mind if we stay for the rest of the meeting?
No, not by all means.
You can use some
ideas. Recenter update. Where's Mac when we need him?
I just wanted to explain that the working group has been meeting every other week or twice a month for some time, and even monthly, weekly for a long time. And we discussed the end of season closure. It was quite a bit of discussion. Do we stay open later because the weather might be good? Do we close when we said we were gonna close, which was the end of October? And at our last meeting, we decided that we would recommend to the committee that we close at the end of October as we originally said. We told people we would be open April through October. And the reason is that there are various projects that the volunteers want to get done before the weather changes. So Alan and Diana and Peter, if you have, Roe, if you have more to add to that, it is in a way disappointing because people are getting excited and, they're still coming and bringing great stuff, but we have a certain window of opportunity to get things done, and because it's our first year, we thought it was appropriate to close when we said we're going to close.
Okay. Any comments? Anybody want to?
Sure, a couple comments. That's true. The early project is we have to replace the door entrance to the what we call the ramp room. Maybe you're familiar with that part, because it's a tiny little door and we couldn't get people through there if we use a display area or for storage. So that's one simple thing from the inside of the center. Our bigger concern has been looking at the what we're calling the annex area. Two issues over there. One is the roof leaks rather considerably, and we've been asking to see if we can get some fixtures
leaky
roof so that we can work inside there a little better and protect the materials that we have. We do want to reorganize that whole area. It's a little chaotic at the moment because we just sort of stuffed everything over there, and we need to re-set up the shelving a little more effectively. Another issue I think that we need to address is the building structure itself on the annex side. I think, David, you might have pointed this out to somebody or pointed it out to me, that in the back wall there is a part of the building that's sagging because the support is not really up to par.
Supporting it. Yeah.
Supporting it. And I think there's a little concern. I don't think it's likely going to happen in the next few weeks, but the long-term liability of that roof structure itself might cave in.
Well, it's really a joint of beam supporting a transverse beam.
No support under it.
Well, visually it's sagging.
Yeah.
But it doesn't appear to be really impaired.
Well, when you look at it, you can see why it's sagging, because there's no really no support underneath. It's just being tied together by boards. So,
what I would suggest is it's not a big deal to repair it, to have it repaired.
No, no, it would require somebody jacking it up and putting in support across.
Yeah, or even stabilizing what's there.
Stabilizing.
With the sag.
It's another project. It's another project.
That's out of our hands. It's a city project.
And you know, longer term, using that area, I guess, may require some additional thinking about federal space. So, again, it's something that has to be figured out today, but I think.
But what is the process for initiating this exploration of these kinds of projects? Some of them we can do on our own,
right?
Replacing the door probably, but.
Well, as I explained in a memo that you guys probably didn't all get, I sent it to the Recenter Working Group. I don't know what it's called, Rowan, can you help me out? When you perform renovations on a city-owned building, there's a process that you are required to go through. First hiring a designer, and that I believe has to go out to bid, and then you have to go put out for bid. Once you have the project plan and it's been approved, then you have to put the actual construction work out to bid. So it's a lengthy process. I spoke to Ned, Diana provided some really great information and details about the condition of the roof. It turns out that the roof itself, the panels are not so bad, it's just that the nails that were used to nail down the sheathing have popped out, and so it's coming in. Did I get that correct? So I shared that with Ned. So when I first spoke to Ned about the roof, he said it can be a long process if we have to hire someone. If we can do it in-house, then that's a little different. However, the person that we have that can work on roofs in-house is out on leave. So we were a little worried about when this is going to happen, and is it going to have to end up happening next year, and blah, blah, blah. So I shared the information that Diana gave me with Ned, and he thinks that because it's minor repair, it might not, first of all, we might have somebody else, if not in TW, it's possible that somebody in Central Services can do it. So he's checking to make sure that this is going to be okay and it doesn't have to go through this long, lengthy process. So he has email or call into the procurement officer here at the city to find out if this is as simple as he and we would all like it to be. So that there's an update on that.
Short of that, is there a possibility of asking some of the same volunteers that worked on the building initially to, because it sounds pretty minor what needs to be done.
I would be surprised myself because it's a roof project, but we can ask.
Last time we were up there, we got.
Yeah, I mean, it's just
there's a little bit of risk being up on that.
Yeah, it's not roof. And we don't know how, it's not a super strong roof, and there's just various issues. Diana spent a lot of time trying to see if we could cantilever out some tarps from inside the roof so that to divert the water to keep things drier in there, and it's not as easy as you would like. But thank you for doing that, Diana.
Roger?
I would suggest for long-term planning, between the city and ourselves, because we're already looking at how much of the annex that we want. Are we going to want more of the annex in the future?
Don't go there yet.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Long-term planning for the use of the space between the city and the reuse.
It's
and the
a building
center.
The city could use if they, the city is using it, but it should be, yeah.
And if they're going to, once we've decided that, then we should look at the whole building and how much
how extensive repairs do we want to do on it?
Right. David, to answer your question, back to your question about what the process is, I don't know, Ro, if it's appropriate to bring it up at a commission meeting.
I'm just making notes to do it. Okay. I didn't add it to the agenda for the coming meeting, but we have an opportunity to add items, so I'm putting this on there to ask and put it on the table.
Or at least could it be looked at, you know, to see if there are structural concerns or what mm-hmm. would happen if we left it on.
Rather than going at it piecemeal, might as well look at the whole thing.
Well, the other thing that I would like to see, and you had mentioned this, and again, I hope it's not stepping on toes, but maybe it has to go through your committee, is to replace some of the signage for that area to make it look more attractive.
Right. I'm going to do that. We have grant money that I'm going to use, and we're going to get some signs.
Oh, great.
Yeah, it just didn't happen this fall, but it'll happen for the spring.
I think it's premature to bring it up until there's a more tangible plan.
Mm-hmm.
Or alternative plans. But
as members of the reuse committee, we can ask Ned what the status of the wall of repair.
Right, but I would just say it doesn't. I don't think it's appropriate to bring it into the meeting.
Right, but because Susan has already started the process.
Right, with that.
Well, the roof repair is one thing, but but also just the whole structure of the building. If there's a sagging, I think it might be appropriate for you guys to mention that the committee has some concerns because of the condition of the building. You don't think that's appropriate?
Let you and I talk about it later.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, David doesn't seem to be that concerned about the structural.
I don't think it's going to fall down.
Yeah.
It looks more threatening than I think it really is.
Right.
But I don't think it should be ignored. That's mm-hmm. a maximum.
Well, it's a city resource that needs potential maintenance.
Okay. Any other?
The more you can push on the
comments
roof.
About what needs to be done to the building. In terms of evaluating closing on October 31st? Because from what I understand, the reason to close on October 31st is because of the work that needs to be done to the building. If there's going to be work done in November, then?
There's reorganization of things, like just the flow of how things have worked. We've learned a lot over the year that we've been open, or over the season. So there's organizational stuff.
We need to cull, you know, some things are not going to make it over the winter. So we're going to have to pull things and make sure they get to secondary outlets or get recycled so that they don't sit there all winter. We have to batten up the hatches for the winter. You know, there are projects like that. Anything paper can't stay in there. Anything that has fabric will get moldy. You know, there's things like that. So there's a little bit of work to be done before it gets really cold out there.
The other thing is we're there on Wednesdays and Saturdays, just volunteering, cleaning up, organizing. People stop in and have things that they want, they ask questions about. So we're going to be, I think it's wise to be officially closed, and we're going to have people come ask us questions.
Yeah, anyway. Even the part of the thing that was discussed is that even when we have a work day, people will come by and ask, they say, oh, can I look around? And even when you say, yes, you can look around, they're distracting and they take you away from this work that you're trying to accomplish. So it's a, you know, being open is just very difficult.
Good. It's
good.
Education.
It's good, but it's
we need to be ready for it.
Yeah. So it's the recommendation of the subcommittee to close on October 31st. Okay.
And Mac is going to wear a costume and encourages all volunteers who are working that day to do it.
Do we need to take a vote on closing on October
31st? I think that would be a good thing,
okay.
Just to make it official.
Great. Someone want to make a proposal?
I'll propose that we officially close the reuse center on the
30th. For the season.
For the season. On the 31st of October.
To the public, yes. Okay. Is there a second for that motion?
Second.
All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
All opposed? All right. It's done. Volunteer rep.
I wanted to ask the group, we've had some really wonderful volunteers, new ones and folks from the committee who have worked hard this season to make this a success. And I wondered what, if anything, should do to recognize and appreciate them? I just wanted to put it up for discussion. I will send out an email, but an email is, you know.
I certainly think we should do something. We've been out of reused card. Thank you.
Reused t-shirts?
Yeah, we've offered t-shirts to people.
Yeah, volunteer
already.
T-shirts, that would be nice.
We've already given the t-shirts to people.
Okay, all right.
Some sort of acknowledgement cards or something.
Right.
Well, do you want to have a gathering, or is there something you want to give to people?
Well, a gathering would be fun. I don't know that people would come necessarily, because people are busy and it's a busy time of year. I'd like to take the opportunity of Thanksgiving to give thanks to people who have been instrumental in work and personal life success. So maybe we could send at Thanksgiving time, send out a special card or something, or
free turkey.
Gift certificates to Eco Building.
I just thought I'd bring it up and see if you guys have any.
Oh, we can brainstorm about it.
You know.
How about?
Oh, go ahead, Brockton.
I was going to say, how about a letter citing the members that have worked, and we send it to Ned and the mayor and the people involved.
That's a great idea,
Rob.
Yeah, that's really good.
And if we can also sort of use it as a volunteer raising.
Recruitment
at the same time for next year. Tell your friends.
And if we're going to do that, it might be, I don't know how feasible this is, Susan, but to sort of summarize the amount of stuff that we have.
It would be fabulous, but that might be hard to do in the next couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Just allude to it.
Many hands make a lot of work done.
One of the things about closing for the season is an opportunity to wrap up and do sort of a public outreach, like a letter to the editor at least, about what we've done this season. And I don't know, I feel like I'd like to have a little bit more time on my hands to do that kind of thing of promoting what we've done and encouraging people to volunteer next year.
It might be better to do that in early spring, when we've had a chance to look at the numbers, and people will be more ready to volunteer in the spring. Because if we do it now, they might forget, but you know.
Maybe both.
So, yeah.
Rogers.
Do we have a date for opening in the spring? Because it'd be nice if we post it on Facebook or whatever, to let them send it out by email, telling, well, we're closing as of, but we will plan.
We've said that we were open. We'd be open April through October. So April.
So first weekend in
first
October,
weekend
April.
April.
Okay. So you want? Do we want to advertise
last year,
that?
Last year it was the
Earth Day, right?
Yeah.
Oh,
that's right. Yeah.
So that was 22nd.
It was the 22nd was a Wednesday, so we did the Saturday after that. But I see no reason to wait for Earth Day to get started.
Earth Day is every
23rd, maybe.
Earth Day is the 22nd, which is a Friday. Right.
So the Saturday, 23rd, or we could do the 16th.
Is there a reason why we'd have to wait till that? I mean, why not earlier?
No, we could do the.
Why not the first? The second.
The second. The first Saturday,
April 2nd.
I mean.
It's a question of the weather, because sometimes it's
April showers.
Last year.
I would vote for the middle of April, 16th.
We don't have to decide now.
Okay. I was just suggesting so we let people know.
Yeah. Right. Okay. Well, let's decide now.
I mean, we're not going to know any different in the middle of winter, right?
I propose the second, and I will be the supervisor on the second.
Okay.
All right. Mark your calendars.
He'll have his long johns on.
And they'll be silver.
April 2nd.
Yes.
Something that we can always advertise.
Excellent, thank you.
So Alan mentioned the projects that we have we've got culling, we've got the doorway project. We would like to have movement on the roof, and I did mention to Ned the group's concerns about if we wait till the spring, then we're, there's so many city projects that happen in the spring that will be at the bottom of the list.
Right.
So, priority-wise. So that was a concern that we'd like to make something happen sooner rather than later. So he's aware of that.
What was the reason that the lines never got painted for the parking?
I do not know.
I'll check on that again. I'll add it to my little
as
list.
It happens,
at this point, it's better to wait till spring.
It is. I agree. And as it happens, the parking and traffic situation, at least on the 10th, when I was supervisor, it was magical. It was great. Everyone parked in the right direction. But before that, it had really been a mess.
Right, right. It would be very helpful to have the lines. Now, one thing that I have a concern about is that they don't sweep before they paint the lines. They have a little blower that kind of, but if there's a lot of sand there, it's going to paint on the sand, and
mm-hmm.
it's going to be. So it would be nice to have a heads up if we could. I will personally be out there with a broom and show
some. Drive at.
There's basically just one area that can really sand.
Okay.
So the other 90%
right.
would easily be blown away.
Susan, what was your hope for the late fall preseason project? Did you want to make
no,
a list
we just
of them?
Did
and,
that.
Okay,
no,
great.
Yeah, no, I mean, we just wanted to let you know and.
Excellent.
Let you know about it.
Roger?
It's curious, you're getting a lot of repeat customers coming to the recenter.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's been, you know, I sat on the task force for what to do after the landfill closed, as did Roe. And one of the things that the community talked about was the fact that they would really miss, if there were no transfer stations, kind of a gathering place, a community center, which the transfer stations had become. And really, the recenter is becoming a community center. There is a regular group of volunteers and there's a regular group of visitors. And it's great.
It's become kind of a third place, which is nice.
Okay, can we move on to event updates?
Sure.
Peter, you want to talk about the tag sale?
The raft?
Weather was fine.
Well, I was thinking about you that day, Peter. That was a beautiful morning.
It was gorgeous.
And while the sun was out, it was warm as chilly when it went in, but it went fine, so we didn't have to worry about rain dates this time. The thing I noticed was that we didn't, well, given 75 spaces we could fill, we only had about 40, roughly. I don't know the exact number.
And how does that compare with last year?
A little bit less, I think. Didn't we have a larger? Well, last year's
remember,
hard because
yeah,
we didn't have
we
the,
two.
You know, we had two events.
Right.
We were set up at the
yes.
rain, in the rain.
And we had two, and we had one in the spring and one in the fall.
Yeah. So it just seemed a little light. So we still need to get the
yeah.
word out for
so the,
people who live in apartments, who live where they can't have a tag sale primarily. I'd say that's still our best audience. It was a weekend that was full of tag sales. I mean, that is, you're concerned about it being too late, but Columbus Day weekend is usually the close of the season sort of a thing.
Well, so I was concerned with maybe that we had light because of the holiday weekend. And you know, because other communities and lots of other places are having tag sale, does that mean we want to have ours too? Because it kind of dilutes the potential crowd. So would it be worth looking into having it earlier?
There was no shortage of people at the recenter on the holiday weekend. We had the usual amount of traffic out there.
I'd say the traffic was good. In fact, the parking was an issue that we have to look at because we need to be able to get people to the front
right.
of Smith Volk when the lot between the gymnasium or whatever it is and that front building.
It would be nice to have some signage for the traffic because people
yeah.
just pull up and they just, you can be standing there pointing them and they're just not even looking at you. They're just looking around and driving wherever
so
they feel like it.
Otherwise, we can have more people doing it, if we can get through every advertising, Facebooks and all that stuff. Other than that, Roger, what else do you
Well, do? We set the date when we set our yearly calendar, and I think, you know, this, we try to balance when we how many things we have within a certain period of time. So I think the date was picked in part with that in mind. So that's one.
Well, no, but Peter actually wanted to have it on Columbus Day weekend. He really likes that idea. But South Hadley had a tag sale that was very well attended on Columbus Day. Was that last year?
Well, it's every year. I had never realized that it's actually for the whole weekend. So when you get there on a Monday, you get in the dregs. So it's but they get a lot of people coming through on a Monday. It's just become, it's built to that.
I do want to say that I advertise this more than we normally advertise. So the fact that we only got 40 is of concern to me. For instance, and I know that Facebook is not perfect, but when one of the indicators is not just how many people scroll past it, but how many likes you get. And I posted multiple postings about the tag sale, and I got, you know, like 50 likes on some of the tag sale stuff. So that means that a lot of people.
What do you normally get?
Oh, 0 to 3. So the word was out about the tag sale, is what I'm saying. and so, at least online, I put it on Craigslist. I posted it to Amherst tag sale on Facebook. There's an Amherst area one. There's a Northampton area one. I posted it there. I posted it to Buy Nothing. I posted it to Western Mass tag sales. We had it in classified ads for 3 days. 3 days, and then prior. And then it was in Hampshire Gazette the week before, and on Friday, Section A, the week of. So it got a lot of press. So something was going on. Maybe something was going on that we only had 40.
You're talking 40 vendors, though.
Mm-hmm.
So what about attendance?
Yeah, how was the traffic?
We ran out of parking, so the traffic was good.
Well, not right now exactly, but I mean, it was getting tight where people were parking, where we would have had booths.
Right. On the far side.
On the football.
And that has never really happened before, has it?
No, not my experience.
It sounds like that the advertising might have been more aimed at participants than vendors, like people coming to shop than coming to.
I agree with that, and I think if we get it out earlier. If you're looking for exhibitors, you got to get it out earlier.
Yeah. So they can come in.
Well, if you have any ideas how to attract people that would sell, let's hear them. Not now, but.
Yeah. Roger, you had a comment?
Well, how many of these have we had? Four? Maybe?
Well, two.
Not really.
It was two a year, and we've got to decide if we want to spring one next year, by the way.
Right. Well, however many October ones, it's not a lot of information or data to inform them. Plot on, we can't figure out. We should at least look at how many people we had, vendors we've had in the past, on what dates. Maybe start playing around with the dates and see what gets more. And it's going to take a long time before we really know what works and what doesn't, what date.
Right. We also the Gazette also had their own in the spring. And they, of course, don't have to pay for advertising, and they advertised it to the hilt.
Alan and then Peter. Oh, you don't have to come, Peter?
So I was thinking if we can partner with the Gazette for a spring one in some way, at least explore it with who's moved on, who's retired now, so.
Jim Foodie.
Because he came and did ours a couple of years ago in the spring.
I just paid it.
Yeah. So they got $30, and I was surprised they did have quite a lot of people set up there for that. Probably less than us, though. I don't know if they had 40 vendors, maybe 25, 30 vendors at their event. So we could decide, should we start negotiations with Jim Foodie to see if we can make that a combined event?
All right, we should move on to the recycling rally. We talked a lot about it already, but
one more thing. There was a cry, as there has been every time, to have more extended hours.
Oh, yes, that's the other thing. Yeah.
Is that a possibility?
It could go till 1, for instance. I mean, very few some end at noon, but we could go till 1, and I think that would, because there was still a decent, very weather dependent. And the other thing I did notice, Deb was getting a lot of sign-ups in the last few days. Because I thought we were going to have about 28 people.
You know? Like two on the same day. Same day sign-ups. One person doubled their size and somebody else came in.
Yeah. So, and some even came in and paid.
Yeah, people were worried about the weather.
Yeah, that's
people might have been thinking maybe I'll
okay, we'll talk about this at the next meeting. Recycling round.
Well, volunteers were in good shape, which is excellent, because that was the issue last time. We've been in touch with Eagle Cycling Circuit.
Gold Circuit.
Cycling. And did you work that out, Susan? He was going to bring 4.
No, I was going to call them.
Okay.
We don't need the...
We don't need that many.
Gaylords.
Yeah, okay. But we'll have a couple, or at least one, right? The Gaylords?
I don't know about that. Well, we can talk.
Okay, we'll talk about that. Yeah. So we're that. The Shredder's coming, which is good. That,
right.
Yeah. And the bikes, not bombs. I don't know what we're going to do about that.
Yeah,
but we'll talk about that.
I will. I'm going to have to correct stuff.
Yeah.
But the first one I posted, when we updated our cover photo, 850 people saw the post, and we got 62 likes and 10 comments, which is phenomenal.
Wow.
And that's for this event coming up on the 7th. And that's just one of the posts.
Wow, that's great.
That's one of the posts, and I've done a couple.
Excellent.
And I'm going to be continuing.
Okay. And we'll talk about flyers. And I'll get them out. So we're in good shape.
Does anybody here repost on their own Facebook pages? We could keep track of that too.
Another one that, so they call it engagement. When people actually do more than just look at it, they call it engagement. And so liking something is like a big, that's a big commitment for somebody to be so enthusiastic that they push the like button. The electronics recycling school event that
Saturday.
Was this Saturday or this
Saturday?
Saturday? I posted that, and that got phenomenal engagement, in probably because of the school community, and so a lot of people shared it and reposted it.
Huh.
So if we can get people.
So there's electronics recycling this weekend?
This Saturday at JFK, 9 to 12.
Okay.
Go it's ahead. A fundraiser.
Yeah, charge. They charge.
Yeah. Same as always.
Yeah.
Okay. December 12th toy exchange. Is Mac running that?
Nope.
Peter, you're running that.
Yeah.
Oh, great.
I checked with Paul Muller-Reed, who I usually never remember. He's the auctioneer who uses Smith Boke and has taken over from George Lewis. He was pretty enthused when I mentioned it to him back in the spring. Now he says he's just too busy, and he had a different impression. He said, well, you have to deliver everything to the warehouse, all the toys to the warehouse up in Deerfield, and it needs to be at least a $30,000 grossing auction. I said, no, you know, that's not us at all. He actually recommended the Rauscher brothers. Anybody heard of Donald Rauscher lives in Florence. He uses the community center to do auctions, and I haven't talked to him yet.
The Ross brothers?
No.
Okay.
Rauscher, R-A-U-C-H-E-R. See if he's interested, and I wanted to get a sense of how much interest we have. I thought we would collect toys through the year. That just hasn't gotten on track yet. So again, it would be very last minute. So we could do, rather than the raffle, which I don't think really gets us anyone. You know, we don't raise any money for us. Thought this could become sort of one of our fundraisers. So we could have a silent auction. That would be one, just simply, instead of a live auction, people just write what they want, and there's the same yoga containers, and they can keep dropping, advancing their bids there until 11 o'clock or whatever. Whether people would have to be there for that or not for the actual, because we don't have to deliver things. But I think we could raise, you know, maybe a couple thousand bucks.
I think
we
raised $200 just through donations. Mm. I kept asking people to please donate to offset advertising costs, etc. And we had, I think, $236 we collected through donations. Yeah.
Roger.
I don't know how difficult it is to set up an auction, but I love the idea of having a guest auctioneer, is it somebody from the city council or the mayor who loves to talk, you know.
Well, it's something that we need to decide pretty darn quick, because if we do something like that, we need to notify the people who donate toys that, that their items might be selected to participate in an auction to raise money for the recenter. So, or not for the art committee.
Diana was before.
Okay.
I just feel like we don't have time to really get through this discussion. I feel like our whole fundraising and auction and that is a kind of a larger discussion, and it's time to be done.
Okay.
So I just, I want to put it on the agenda for next time, I guess.
Well, by next time, by next time it's going to be too late.
Well,
depending
upon when we meet. Roe, what's your
Well, I was not... didn't have exactly the same thing, but this is a very complicated discussion. First of all, if we are to have an auction, what are we have money in our account. We don't have to raise money, first of all. If we're raising money for another group to donate to them, but it's a very involved, it is an involved discussion.
Diana?
We have just a comment on what you were saying. We have been at the recenter over the last month or so, been asked, when people bring something in that we think is auctionable or tag saleable or whatever, we have been asking the donator if they mind if we use it for a fundraiser and marking that in that they said it was okay into the box. So we have been sort of doing that more officially lately.
In terms of next meeting, I would suggest that we meet maybe earlier than the 19th, and that way we can have more organizational discussion about the December 12th toy exchange. How do people feel about that?
It's a good idea.
So maybe meeting on the 12th?
Yeah.
Sure. November 12th, is that?
Yeah.
Well, even the 12th, yeah, I mean, we can do it.
Oh, well, we can meet on the 5th.
Yeah. Well, it's just that the sooner the better. I mean, the press release is going to have to go out.
Okay, so how do people feel about meeting in 2 weeks on the 5th? And that would be on our November meeting.
Well, I won't be.
I think the 12th is enough. You've got a full month from that date, from the 12th to the 12th of December. So I don't think we could really have it unless we're looking for donations. We could do that right away.
Yeah, but we could do the 12th.
You could advertise without specifics about an auction aspect of it.
Rhoda, does the 12th work for you?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
This is for the next meeting.
Here's the next meeting. Here will be on the 12th.
The one something we didn't get to is the, as far as new business, is the America Recycles Day is November 20th. I want to say, I don't know the exact date.
That's separate from the recycling
that's
day.
That's the reuse. They were talking about
recycling.
Yeah, there's a National Reuse Day that's starting to be promoted, and
they're saying
October.
Right.
But
this
but
is October 20th.
America Recycles Day is in November. So I think it's after the 12th, so we might be able, I think it's the 19th actually, so we might be able to still do something, even if it's a letter to the editor or something. We can talk about it next week.
Is there a National Reduce Day?
There should be. Actually, there is a
lifestyle diet, basically.
Any other new business?
New business. Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Okay, we are adjourned. Oh, we didn't talk about the...